concert is by a composer who's not so well known, Berlioz. A whole half of Berlioz? Is he a composer that you're particularly fond of?
At the last few years, yes, I've discovered and been given a lot of his music that wasn't previously available. He's a great South American character, you know, a bohemian sort of character who's loved by all the people he came in contact with. A great virtuoso guitarist himself. He was born in Paraguay in 1885, died in Ecuador in 1944, spent most of his life in South America except for one short trip to Europe, and some disciples and pupils have got some of his music, a lot of his music left over which wasn't published, and I've been lucky enough to get hold of that. You know, they've sent it to me, and some of it's been taken off old gramophone records. At the moment I'm very fond of his music. I think he's one of the great guitar composers, you know, original guitar music, rather like a sort of Chopin of the guitar. And I think he's definitely, the music now has come to stay. There's so much of it. I've done a whole recital of his music in Paris in March, you know, an hour and a half. It has to be quite a good composer to keep everyone awake for an hour and a half, one composer.
Thank you. Thank you.
As a trailblazer in this particular field, the fact that you actively participate so often in so many musical forms, you play at jazz clubs, you commission works for electric guitar. Do you think that by putting your personal stamp on it, you're persuading young people who may have taken up the guitar, perhaps for purely entertainment reasons, that there's something more in it and much wider? Are you conscious of this?
I'm very conscious of that, and I would hope that that's the case, but I don't. At the same time, I don't view myself as a trailblazer. See, I don't do it for a particular purpose. That's important. I do it in response to the things that I like. Now, if I like or use electric guitar or play in Ronnie Scott's jazz club, and I play Bach and Scarlatti and Albanus, I don't play jazz there, it's because my life, for example, in London, has led me into contact with these people. I've done film sessions on classical guitar. I've met the other guys that are playing in the orchestra, you know, or I've met a composer like Stanley Myers. I met doing one of his film scores. We just got chatting and we thought, well, let's go into the studio and put a record together. We made a record called Changes. And yet then people would say afterwards, oh, you know, you're really they read too much into the title of the record, which is an accident, Changes. Yeah, you're changing your direction, you really want to concentrate on this, and this is you, you know, this is you trailblazing, if you like. I said, not a bit of it. Stanley and I, we were sort of sitting around after doing the film session, we thought it'd be quite fun to go in the studio with 30 session players and put together a record of arrangements of bits and pieces. It's exactly what happened, you know. Now, I'm very conscious that that then does what you were saying. It then means that other people are, in a sense, guided, it's too strong a word, but are influenced. You know, and they think that this is a nice thing and that I'm making new opportunities. And I think it does. But I think it's more a response of me, of mine, to a situation. And I would hope that other guitarists, other musicians would have the same response. You know, just to recognize that music and meeting other musicians in different circumstances is really what it's about. It's what they did in the 18th century.
Thank you.
I don't, certainly don't think I'll be giving concerts for the rest of my life. I think that's for sure. But I also think that I don't think anyone else is going to be giving concerts for the rest of their lives. I think it's already started with the interest in older music and medieval music. I think that's in a rather important way, it's a parallel to people wanting things on a smaller, more community-based social style of living. And I think life's going to get like that generally. I think it's going to have to, you know. Big cities and industrial complexes are not going to survive, you know.
Are you going to continue living in London?
I wouldn't mind living in the country at all at some stage, but for the moment I love London. I couldn't live anywhere else, you know. It's just wonderful, but it's a seduction, you know. It's something you know is dated. It can't last. But while it's there, I enjoy it, you know.